Hello, this is Hero of YouTube channel. In this video, I will review for you one nice retro machine. It's the Apple Power Macintosh 7300/200, which means PowerPC machine at 200 MHz CPU. Inside there is 604E CPU on special CPU card. There is also a special graphics board added and SCSI card inside. I'm using this retro keyboard and now it works the operating system on this Apple 16-inch color display. This excellent machine has in front 3.5-inch bay, which is occupied on the right with CD-ROM drive. There is also floppy drive, which is with door protected from dust, and this is empty here for zip drive, tape drive and so on. Right now it has MacOS 9.1 installed, which is the latest operating system that it supports. No MacOS X or MacOS 10, but this one is nice anyway. You can play music, edit movies, games, Photoshop, picture processing, desktop publishing and anything nice for 1997 in February when this machine was released in this desktop form factor. It's not very lightweight, but it's relatively small desktop. On the rear there are several ports. One very interesting port for me is the availability of one network with Cat5. You can see, so I can connect to the internet with this machine and browse even now in 2023. Here is the power cord, and from the power you can also send electricity to the display and it can even control the display as well. This is expansion possibility. Here display is also available on the motherboard. Sound, microphone, 3.5mm jacks and 3 PCI ports, one of which is occupied with additional graphics card and the other is with the SCSI controller, which is inside, no need to go outside. This is the cable which I'm using, standard Mac cable for connecting to the Macintosh 16-inch color display. Let me show you more of the machine. Right now with Mac OS 9.1 I can, for example, play Amiga mod files and inside is an Aminet CD insert, so I can select SPAVI because I'm in Intel, and here it is. I was able to unearchive some mod files and I can start them directly with Mac Mod Pro. Let me show you an example. Camcorder is not exactly syncing with this, but it's because it's different. Refresh rate. Anyway, let's go to Programmi, Musica, Mac Mod. You see it's very fast, 200 MHz, and for example this mod file, play. Inside is a built-in speaker. I can take out this and insert a music CD which will switched immediately to a truly multimedia machine. For example, this Happy Hour, unboxed in another video. Let's insert it and stop. And now it will play as soon as it loads and recognize the CD audio. Additionally, with MacOS 9, I have this track selection very fast. And I can eject it with software from the MacOS and programs. Let me show you here about this Mac. Right now it has installed 256 megabytes of RAM. And this Mac mod is taking 3.5 megabytes, while the operating system is taking 41.5 megabytes of the precious memory. In Apple System Profiler, there is much more information to be shown about the machine. Right now it's loading, and as soon as it loads, I will be able to show you more information about the machine. Here it is, MacOS version, Italian, QuickTime, memory, Apple Talk, IP, and many other features of the machine. Let me scroll down. And inserting it a floppy will show me the disk drive. Here is Microsoft Office 98 suite on the machine. I have Excel, PowerPoint, Word, and everything needed for any business and desktop publishing. Macintosh editor of Microsoft Word. For sound editing, here is the nice Sound Edit 16 version 2, which allows me to convert to CD audio. Play. Play as instrument and loop. Extracts convert CD audio. So many sound effects for movies editing and making YouTube videos. Here is Adobe Premiere 5.1. I can open new project and monitor directly. Really truly multimedia machine. Here is iView Multimedia and Premiere TIFF. EuroCalc. For calculating money and so on. Magic Scan for scanning documents. UMAX. Poser 3.0. And many other software titles. It's really rich in software titles. Wow! For graphics, I have Adobe Illustrator 9.0. Wow! And many other software titles. For example, here is Norton System Works 1.0 with speed disk file saver on arrays, volume recorder, live update. Here are my drives on SCSI buses. CD Finder. As you can see, it's very fast opening of the software, and the operating system works very conveniently. No need to wait for simple tasks. Opens fast. Right now my resolution is on this 16-inch display 832x624 at 75 Hz with million colors. It can also be thousands or 256. This is for compatibility with some other softwares. It can also be grayscaled in 256 colors. You see very fast switching between the modes, and I have many control panel options. Monitor, mouse, modem, memory. No virtual memory, as it doesn't need, with 256 megabytes of RAM. PageMaker 6.5. Now let me show you what's inside the machine. Unlike other computers from Apple, this one is very easy to open. Just push these two buttons, and here is the machine from inside. Seagate Barracuda ATA4 hard drive, 20 gigabytes, but this is not the only one hard drive inside. Here is the floppy with standard Mac floppy cable. Here is revealing the interesting part. This is the CPU card, which is on special slot. And here is the graphics card. Additionally, the disk controller with SCSI cable, and under is the main board, motherboard, removing the SCSI cable, then these two switches, and now I can lift, but need to remove the power cable, and I'm lifting together with the power supply. Very interesting. Here are the memory, this is the battery. There, memory modules, 256 megabytes recognized. Floppy drive, CD-ROM drive, SCSI cable, and another SCSI there. One cable, integrated video, so many chips and no CPU. This one there is the CPU card. After working, touching it, it's not hot at all. Very power efficient machine. Closing it back together is very easy. Just pull this black stopper here, swipe down, turn this back on, and lock. Then insert the SCSI cable into place and make it comfortably going. And now it's ready to be closed and used again. Under the hard drive is an empty drive-by. For example, I can place tape drive there. HDD floppy drive, CD-ROM drive, reading only. Here is the power supply of the machine. Here is the power button, which leads to this button there. Average consumption of the machine when loading the operating system is around 60 to 65 watts, which is very good consumption, much less than the display itself. After loading the operating system, I can work with it. One excellent, good looking computer. Thanks for watching my video. See you in my next videos. As you can see, it's ultimate working machine. Page maker. So many software titles, it's hard to show you them all, but be sure that it's powerful machine and it was one of the best available in early 1997. Thanks for watching my video. See you in my next videos. If you want more software and hardware reviews of this machine, don't hesitate to write in the comments below. See you.